Dr. Angelynne Enoka, she is Samoan, she's a professional, and she's transgender. This gathering marks years of sacrifice, hard work, and many, many obstacles to this point. Born in Samoa, from a young age, Angie always knew who she was.
I grew up in Tongafofua, so it's very central. We're close proximity to Apia. I think for everyone in our village in Tongafofua, they always see me as an effeminate boy. I think there were two things that Dad was afraid of. He was afraid that I'll be bullied at school and people pick on me. And also he's afraid that I may not have a comfortable life, but he loves me.
With her family's support, top grades in high school earned Angie's scholarship in New Zealand.
My family is very supportive of me being this way, and I look back, without that support, I wouldn't get where I am today. I remember the day when I came by myself to catch the plane to come to New Zealand, and I see my mum and dad. We didn't have air bridges at Faleolo. They were waving at me to say goodbye.
In 1999, at the Auckland Institute of Technology to study communications, Angie knew how to handle certain moments.
I remembered my first lecture that I attended, that he read out all the roll call of students, and he read my name out three times because he kept on saying Andrew Joseph, and I said, yep. And he goes, Andrew Joseph, and I said, yep. Andrew Joseph, and he said, that's me.
In time, Angie changed her name legally and embarked on a career in communications, mostly around the public sector in Wellington. She continued to study, adding to her CV when she graduated this year with a Doctor of Philosophy from Massey University. Her thesis on the unfair portrayal of Pacific Island workers in the RSE Scheme 20.
Angie's topic is extremely important. She discovered that there were racism problems in the media, but they weren't the ones that she thought they were. They were more connected with exploitation of people for their labour, dehumanisation, and thinking about particularly media coverage of a different group of Pacific people whom nobody had ever scrutinised the media study of before.
And proudly flying the flag high for the transgender community.
I think it's just the early transition to New Zealand that people have absolutely no idea. At the time, probably they've seen drag queens or whatever the names, but they're used to the ideal of someone like me on the streets or entertaining at nightclubs, you know, or showgirls, but not really around the educational settings.
It's really hard life. You know, you have the racism against you, but also the sexism and the homophobia. But, you know, for me, you know, it's about achievement and it's about the future direction that whawhawhine is.
And taking time out with friends and family, what next for Dr. Angie Enoka?
The next step for me is just to do well and do very well in the role that I'm about to go into in education and just to make a difference. It's been a very hard journey. And in the midst of all those business, I just wanted a work-life balance so I can spend a little bit of time, you know, at home with, you know, with Dave and also my two dogs.